I'm scared to soft talk. Oh, hang on. Yeah, I'm trying a new beginning today. Sorry, a couple minutes late. I took some medicine before stream because my throat was not sounding very nice and clear. I still have a cough and a little, you know, throat scratchiness, so it is what it is. Suffering. Not really. It's just annoying, you know? Anyway, hello, Guumies. I hope this prop is not too loud. Oh, I can feel the scratch. It will get better eventually. Sometimes I just have to warm up my ASMR voice. Like right now, it sounds really weird. Yeah, just gonna warm it up a bit. Cause I don't talk like this normally, you know? Like, you know, I talk normal like everybody else. But soft talking is different than normal talking, so... Oh, why is my screen always broken? Why? I only notice this when I start stream. The bottom is messed up. Keep clearing my throat. Clip. yeah, I'll fix it in a minute. Shin, thank you for the 16 months. Welcome back. Yeah, it's the filter. Must be fixed. It doesn't happen often. It's like once every minute or something. So I can fix it. Hang on one second. this shouldn't happen anymore now. Should be all fixed. Shin, thank you for the 16. Hello, hello, welcome, welcome, welcome. Welcome, 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 welcome. Yeah, I thought we would do some taps today. Ew. Oh man, it's pretty bad right now. I'm so sorry, everyone. I just have like this residual crud lingering from being sick. It really sucks. Oh well. Let's just all be comfy today. I feel like I have a slime stuck in my throat. Yeah, the main sickness has been long gone. It's just all the throat congestion, the cough. And the low energy is still around a little bit too. It sounds like one ear is louder than the other. But it shouldn't be. I've been drinking so much tea. Is too loud. The tapping mic. Hope you all enjoy your gift and membership. It sounds good? Okay. I think the last stream there might have been a couple props that were a little too loud. I think the volume's pretty even. I just think I wasn't touching the mic close enough on this side. warm up my soft talking voice so I can roar again. Roar for chat. I do have some other stuff I haven't used in a while though. Some requests that you guys have made, like a tuning fork. I know you guys really like the roller. Deep cup whispers. I can't really do that with this mic. The only way I could do that is if I talk really close like this, but I think it's too loud. Maybe I'll do a little bit later. Yeah, the roller is nice, right? Sometimes I have like, oh, I hope I'm not doing it too fast. Oh yeah, I'm like really zoomed in. I can zoom out a little bit. I think I'm a little too close right now. There. I like being closer when I do ASMR. I forgot there's a blowing emote on YouTube. And the cat. The Rolling Stones. Do you like the Rolling Stones? The Rolling Guumies. Usually, I don't think I use a prop this slowly. I think I'm usually like... I don't want to do it too harsh, but yeah. What you would call that one? You like the comfy ASMR sign? Well, the text looks a little messed up actually. It's one of my, sounds good, but then sometimes it's a little too weird, scratchy. Sometimes. I'm trying to be a little more delicate. The deeper crinkles. Let's try this one too. We have a sponge. Oh god, sorry. That was aggressive ASMR for whoever wanted that. Oh, I like this one. Those are like crinkle and scratch. Crinkle, 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 crinkle. some particle effects on the sides. I do, I do. I have bokeh in the background. It's very, very light. Might be hard for you guys to see. Yeah, it's there. Maybe I should make it more visible. Second PC. But that isn't like too extra to have a second computer. I mean, I guess for work it wouldn't be extra. Every time I get a new computer, though, it's after like, like 4 years, and the technology always changes. It is becoming easier, I think. Can I listen to my own ASMR? Yeah. Yeah, I definitely can. It's gonna sound weird, but I've heard clips of my ASMR before and I didn't know it was my ASMR. I didn't recognize myself and I didn't know who it was, and I was like, oh, this is really nice. And I was like, wait, that's me? What? I had no idea. Because the monitoring I hear from the props sounds different than it does for you guys. And my head voice sounds a lot different than my actual voice. Yeah, so for me. No, 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 for my cat. It's really nice too because I can have more litter box space. So I have a couple litter boxes right now. Because of, like, you know, a lot of people will say you're supposed to have one litter box per cat. Well, I think some people say you're supposed to have, like, a communal litter box too. So, like, if you have two cats, you need three litter boxes. And I'm just like, I can't deal with that and I don't have enough room. So I have like two. I clean them every single day. Every day. Rarely do I ever go more than a day without cleaning it. But I have three cats, so. And I want them to be happy, so I clean it every day. But you know, if you stay on top of it, it's not so bad. Yeah, I know, it's crazy, right? And one litter box is supposed to support up to four cats. Because it cleans itself after every time your cat uses it. So it's just always clean. So that's pretty cool. Probably just don't have them use a toilet with the bidet, because that might be bad. But then, you know, when your cat gets old, what are you gonna do? And I'm afraid, like, if I got a kitten and trained it, it would fall into the toilet. What's the name of the litter box? But then I think to myself, all these devices are so expensive, right? So expensive, thousands of dollars for things, right? I pay a lot of money to be a VTuber for work, for my job, you know, you guys know. And then I'm like, okay, well, buying this litter box is really expensive, but it will help cut down a part of my daily life. A chore in my daily life. It will help. So, it's worth it to me. It's worth it. So yeah, I'm trying it out. Let's see if I... You know, if it doesn't work out, you can always return it. So yeah, it's more practical, I guess is what I'm trying to say. More practical. Oh my gosh. Other cats tested my litter box to make sure it's good. No. Because it's kind of like a mini computer with sensors. Well, kind of. Not a computer, but, you know, a machine. Test this one out, but we'll see if it's any good. Guumies, comfy. It's a little hard to hear. Oh, snappy. Okay, what about this one? Is this one loud enough for you guys? Is it loud enough? Yeah, I like this one a lot. There's a lot of different sounds with this prop. That kind of sounds like a... I don't know, it's a nice texture sound. Along with the little marbles inside. Something I would have to use as a prop. I wonder if I can screech. I can. Yay! Finally! I haven't been able to make that noise in like a month because of being sick. I also don't feel like coughing yet. That's pretty nice. Yay! Maybe I'm almost healed. Yeah, the marbles are a nice touch. Have like a nice layer. It's a little rare. Yeah. Yeah. Oh my god, that was a little weird. Still throw problems. Yeah. Yeah. Okay, maybe not fully. I like being able to make high-pitched weird little noises. But I'll stop doing it now, sorry. My S's are a little sharp today too. Sometimes it sounds like a dog whistle, a little bit. Sorry if you have a dog, or are a dog. Yippee. There you go. Oh yes, I must be a dog. Well, you know. You never know. Maybe a really smart dog gets access to your computer and accidentally clicks the right amount of buttons and mouse keys, and bam, IkuStream opens up and he's just sitting there listening. I feel like coughing. Maybe ear blowing a little too much. You like the yippee? Yippee! It actually sounds nice. That's the best part of it. Is the K. Does it have to be the drawn out yippee? Guess what? I ordered new props again. I'm really, really, really excited for these ones because I think they're gonna sound amazing. And they shouldn't be very hard to use. It's gonna gonna be something similar to the, you guys remember the slug? Oh, it's a little loud sometimes. It's gonna kind of be like this. I think it might sound a little different though. Slug is good, haters gonna hate. Oh, you don't remember. Oh, okay, okay. Yeah, it's good, right? It's a 3D printed slug. This is actually a really nice fidget toy. Can you know where you be? When I feel like it. I don't usually do, you know, things on command. Unless it's a membership based on my stream. Or if somebody super chats. And even then, it has to be something that, like, I'm okay with. And that I can actually do and that's allowed. There's new people here. Do fidget spinners make good sounds? They can, yeah. They can. As long as you don't accidentally hit the microphone with it while it's spinning. Well, the problem is if you start doing stuff for one person, then everybody's gonna ask for stuff. And then they're gonna keep asking over and over and over, so... You know, I just kinda... do it randomly. Or at least I do. Just, you know... Sometimes I'll, like, do what chat says. Or requests. You want the one at the end? Okay, so yeah, there's the slug. Sleep instead. I think I need to take these out actually. Take them out. Yeah, that sounds different. Can you guys hear the difference? Detached a lot of these because they're stuck together, but I guess I didn't. Yeah, I like the wood sound, and then there's also rubber. That makes nice. I was really surprised at how many like different little cues this prop can make and how good it sounds. Yeah, some prompts are a little quieter. Run! 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 Why does the end of my roar sound like I'm wheezing? That doesn't sound as good as I thought. Can I take out two of these? interesting sound. I think that was my chair. I'm sorry. My face is behind my hand. It looks weird. I can't control it. But yeah. That's what the rubber on the bottom of the stamp sounds like. Do I ever make myself sleepy if I'm doing ASMR? Sometimes. If you go back to like my older ASMR streams, I've started falling asleep on stream before. That was when I started double streaming and I was just so tired from streaming on the purple place and then streaming here and and then, I don't know, I was also really, really, really busy. IRL at the time, I was so tired. I was starting to fall asleep on stream. Only with ASMR. Yeah, definitely was overwork. I was not sleeping enough. So I'm kind of wondering, do you guys retract your messages because you don't want me to see it? Because I can see it. I can just click and I can see what he said. I don't know why some people retract them so much. Not just you, Fairy Ball, other people too. Maybe because, like, typo, maybe. I don't know. Should see y'all. I am omnipotent within my own stream. You don't see them in the chat? You don't see message retracted? Maybe only mods and streamers can see that. If it's retracted, that means the person who typed it deleted it. So, like, fixing... Yeah, okay, okay. I see a lot of other people retract their messages, though. Like, they say something a little shady, and they retract it, and it's like... Excuse me, viewer, just because you retracted it doesn't mean it didn't happen. Well, I think some people retract, like, they mistyped it or something. But other people are just being, bad. Bad viewer. Cool. You can't ring a bell, Sonny. That's true. I recently heard another thing from a grandma, from a granny. Wait, what did she say? She said, there's two things you should spend your money on to make sure they're good quality. Pair of shoes and your bed. Because if you're not in one, you're in the other. And it's so true. Grannies and their wisdom. What the heck? And like that is so true. Good quality bed, good quality shoes. That is very true. Nowadays, probably a good quality like chair at your desk. If you like work a lot on your desk, probably as well. Good chair. Pair of shoes. Sorry. Sometimes I like slur my words together. Yeah. Pair of shoes. Shoes. Chair, shoes. And bed, yes. Or if you're a couch potato, make sure you have a good couch. Or a good chair. Like, living room chair. Oh, I definitely think bed, shoes. And if you, like, work out your desk, a good chair, too. I don't know if this was a TikTok or if it was a YouTube short, I can't remember. But I saw this clip of this girl who was like gonna go do like a parachuting thing. It was like, you know, I like a class like for fun. And there was a dude attached to the parachute with her as like the like helper, the guide. I don't know what they're called. That was so funny. She was a heavier set gal, and when the parachute took off, she fell forward and she slid along the ground the whole way until the parachute like took them off the mountain. Luckily, she was sliding in grass, but still, it looked kind of painful. And the instructor fell on top of her. It was like watching someone go sledding across grass. It was so funny. I hope she was okay. She's probably fine, but oh my gosh. That would be so embarrassing. But she was like 3 times his size, so it looked comical. And the person recording was just laughing so hard. There's like 4 people watching this happen and they're losing it. I think they were fine though. I don't know. I didn't read like the comments or anything, but it was definitely something, a sight to behold. Yes. A cartoon moment for sure. I think I put this on backwards. Okay, we're just gonna put that over there. And take out this one. Oh no, a sliver. Yeah. Sometimes I don't like watching those because, like, it looks like it hurts. Like, the fail is painful. People just do like the dumbest stuff. The dumbest ideas ever. The people still use Vine. There's no people used to say it for the Vine. For the gram. Yeah, Vine is dead, I think. Okay, boomer. I never used Vine. I wasn't into it. I just remember seeing, hearing people say for the Vine. For the Vine. For the gram. Didn't TikTok come after Vine? Or did TikTok start while Vine was still around? How old is TikTok? In my day. Well, that sounds interesting. Wait, let me layer a little more. MySpace! I've heard the legends of MySpace. The legends. When was MySpace out? Was that in the 90s? No, that would be too old, right? Oh, TikTok started literally when Vine ended. Oh, okay, no wonder it went from one to the other. MySpace came up before Facebook, right? By like a couple of years. HTML coding, oh no. Were you guys taught how to do HTML in school? I was never taught HTML. I didn't learn HTML until like after school, like after high school. I just learned it on my own, like online. But I remember people being like, oh my god, you don't know how to use HTML, what the heck? Like, so judgmental. Back in your day, tell me, are you a granny? Dude, Excel is so complicated. I'm still like taken aback by how much Excel can do. It's crazy. It's so complicated. It's like its own coding program. Don't bully Grandma Tammy. Anyone can get a job if you know Excel. I think I agree. I agree with your cousin. Excel is like, bruh. Excel is too powerful. Just used. Sounds very similar to some other props that I have, but I wonder who the oldest person in chat is. Oh, my nails are so short right now, I can't. I cannot tap. I know you would be a grandpa, but it's funny calling you grandma because your name's Tammy. I don't know a grandpa Tammy anywhere. Well, I do have all my YouTube statistics. Like an age group that's like 65 plus or something. Which is cool. Because, like, I don't know, I wouldn't think a 65 plus would be interested in a ASMR or an anime girl. You're Gen Z? Which one's that? How old are Gen Zers? Yeah, that's my question. Is anybody older than a millennial? I think millennials go up to like 40 something, right? That is true. Ikumi is more for everyone. Scratch. I know Z is for you. Oh, wait. Gen X, I think. Not Gen Z. Isn't Gen Y millennials? Is Gen X the one that came before millennials? I don't know. Okay, so Zoomer, 96 to 2010. Zoomers are getting old now. I think there's like, what, 25-year-old Zoomers now? Gen X was born in the 70s. Oh, okay. A millennial is Gen Y, right? Ah! They only call them millennials because, you know, it's the turn of the century. Gen X, millennials, aka Gen Y. Why? Why? Just why? Gen Y, are we here? And Gen Z and Gen Alpha. Okay. And then, aren't boomers before Gen X? Or is there another generation between boomers and Gen X? Cool generation. Everybody always makes fun of Zoomers. Boomers than X. There's nothing between boomers and X? That's kind of weird. Because I thought boomers were the parents of Gen X. Shouldn't there be something in between? Well, I guess not. I guess millennials could be parents to zoomers, technically. If it's an old millennial and a young zoomer, then I guess technically. Aren't millennials mostly the parents of Gen Alpha? We have boomers, the baby boomers. Right? After the war, they just had lots of babies, so they're called the boomers. The baby boomers. I think I'm confused though. Yeah, X and the boomers, I guess, does make sense. Old millennials. I guess an old zoomer could have a Gen Alpha kid. Like 30s and 40s? 30s and early 40s, I think? And then zoomers are like... Wait, no! Aren't some millennials still in their 20s? Millennials are really big generation. Doesn't millennial go from late 20 to early 40? That's kind of crazy. That's kind of crazy to me. That's such a huge gap. Where do I put this thing? I don't have any room. Yeah, because zoomers are like mid-20s and lower. Yeah, aren't there some millennials who are like 26 to like, I don't know. I'm gonna guess 45, but I don't know. Yeah, my one brother is a zoomer. And my other brother's a millennial. And I am 269 years old. 269. I'm like granny. Oh, so you're a zoomer if you're 27 or lower? There's a lot of overlap between zoomer and millennial. Like, I feel like there's at least 5 years of gray area overlapping. Depending on how you were raised. Your dog is Zenji. Alright, Gen Z. Okay, so what's the oldest age for Zoomer? Get off their lawn. Zoomers go up to 30? Really? Well, yeah. I guess that makes sense. That's kind of why I said it. I feel like there's like an overlap of like 5 years of gray area where you could kind of be a Zoomer or kind of be a millennial. That's just your opinion, I see. That reminds me of what Amazon said. They said, you will own nothing and you will be happy. Crazy times, crazy times. Gonna move to Italy after I say this. But I recently heard that Italy is a really good place to buy a house because you can get like a 4,000 square foot house for like, I think it's 80,000. $80,000 you can buy a 4,000 square foot house in Italy, and then you spend like what, like 20 to 40k making it look immaculate and amazing, and then boom, giant, beautiful, gorgeous, amazing house with all the latest appliances and everything and upgrades for only like 120k max. Time to move to Italy, right? You won't eat the bugs. Commute to your job would be horrible. Oh no. Yeah, the down payment is definitely the tricky part. Hey, Italy is a really beautiful place. And I'm talking like Sicily, where it's really nice. also it's the Mediterranean climate, so it's like so beautiful. And the food. And imagine all the stuff you're close to over there. You can literally take a train to so many places. House is cheaper than your car. Oh my god. Wow. I would get along with people in Italy so well. Just smile and make hand gestures and you're in. Compliment them on their food. The Godfather. You're all doing the finger gestures, hand gestures. Yeah, that's all it takes. The Ikumi. Yeah, exactly. Okay, I'm getting a little distracted and derailed. Creaky. What if it's not under the blanket? You're from Italy? Cool. Is it nice to buy a house there right now? I wonder if it'd be hard to move there. It'd be hard to get citizenship in Italy as an American. They really scared you with some of their drivers. And you just can drive however you want in Europe, right? Oh my gosh, I would definitely drive on the wrong side of the road for sure, 100%. And I'll be like, oops, hee hee. Almost crash into somebody. on about since, like, I was born. I guess the area I grew up in was more progressive with roads. I don't know. Yeah, I've driven on roundabouts my entire life. I like roundabouts. Sometimes they're annoying, though. When people, like, don't follow the rules. I'm walking in. You'd probably be insulted if I said that. I have gone around a double roundabout, yes. It was a little scary. As long as you know the rules of the road, it's not that hard. The Swindon Magic Roundabout, I never even heard of that. I read your comment before I even saw your name, and I was like, that kind of sounds like hobos, and then I was like, oh yeah, sure enough. I've never been to Europe before, but I do want to go. It's fine as long as you know how they work. Free for all roundabouts, good luck. I'll just get out and walk, pull my car. I don't trust it. It's like when you're riding your bike and sometimes it just looks a little too crazy, and you just get off the bike and walk the bike. It's like that. Where is the Swindon roundabout located? Am I even saying that right? My grandma used to go to Italy like every single year. I do have confidence in it, yeah. Oh, Swindon's in the UK. Oh, okay. Oh no, it's in the UK, I'm scared now. Question, but I am not expecting a random answer. I'm expecting a precise answer. Guumies. Yes, fear the British. Oh my gosh. I mean, like, if I just act like really rude, I will fit in. they won't see me as weak, right? British things I've seen, they don't seem that rude or that bad. Give them attitude. It's okay. In parts of the US, there's reputations like that too. Like on the East Coast, I'm gonna be sassy. I'm gonna have moxie. The bants, yeah, banter. The bits and the bants. Go to Paris. Oh, wait, yeah, that's true. People can be pretty rude there, right? The rest of France is fine. Okay, okay. I did have a random question, but I don't remember what it was. I already forgot. Yeah, my brain kind of works in like a star shape. So like it's kind of a circle in the middle. And then the pointy parts are really random tangents. And eventually gets back around. Sometimes it works. I'm doing good. I'm doing good. Distracted. It's a part of my brain I cannot fix. I have ADHD, so you know. It's in my DNA. I am programmed for distractions. Thank you. eventually I will remember. Even if it's tomorrow, eventually I will remember. Yeah, during Twitch stream I probably will. Randomly blurt it out. I think they're born that way. They get stuck that way. I'm pretty sure. There's so many of them that they get stuck in a clump and the other tails get stuck together. I think it's very rare though. Like there's only ever been like a mummification or something found. Should have left that on. Oh, jeez. Right. just